Transmission line is one of the important topic that you study in your electromagnetics. Basically, transmission line is a form of guided propagation. See, when electromagnetic wave propagates through the free space, through the unbound media, free space is an unbounded media. That is non-guided form of propagation. But when EM wave travels through the waveguide, or when EM wave travels across the transmission lines, it is guided form of propagation. And I have observed that most of the students fail to visualize how electromagnetic wave is established over the transmission line. See, what they think? We apply the voltage and current at the source end. We get voltage and current at the load of the transmission line. Then why do we use the wave equations in between? From where does the transverse electromagnetic wave appear on the transmission line? So in this video, let's try to visualize how transverse electromagnetic wave, how EM wave is established in the transmission lines. Consider this simple two-wire transmission line, as you can see from the screen. Assume that wires are made up of perfect conductor and the medium between these two conductors is perfect dielectric. Assume that you have applied the high frequency voltage source at the source end of the transmission line and it is delivering the power to the load connected at the load end. Now you know that transmission lines can be very long. Transmission line arrangement is used to deliver the high frequency power over the large distance, very large distance. The length of transmission lines could be in kilometers. Yes or no? So forget about that thing. Let's try to focus on the title of our video. I want to make you visualize how the electromagnetic wave, the transverse electromagnetic wave, establishes over this two-wire transmission line. So as we have applied the high-frequency voltage source at the source end, as we have applied the voltage at the source end, the current will be set up in the transmission line, as you can see from the screen. Yes or no? The circuit will be closed and current will be set up in the transmission line, as you can see from the screen. Now, let's assume any particular instant of time. Let's assume positive half cycle of the input voltage. So for that particular instant of time, let's assume that the upper line of the two-wire transmission line is at positive potential and lower line of this transmission line is at negative potential. So for that instant of time, the directions of current will be as you can see from the screen. Now consider this small portion of this two-wire transmission line. And now, my dear, remember that when current flows through any wire, when current flows through the conductor, the magnetic field H is set up around that conductor. Yes or no? Magnetic effect of electric current. When current flows through any wire, when current flows through any conductor, the magnetic field will surround that conductor and its direction. The direction of magnetic field, it is given by right hand thumb rule. Am I right? Thumb, it is the direction of current. And fingers, it is the nature of magnetic field, H. So my dear, look carefully this small portion of transmission line. In the upper wire of two wire transmission line, current is coming like this towards the load. So the magnetic field will set up, as you can see from the screen. While in the lower line, lower wire, the magnetic field will be set up according to right hand thumb rule, as you can see from the screen. Yes or no? As currents are flowing, so magnetic field will be set up. So my dear, look carefully to the screen. You can say that the magnetic field is set up within the dielectric present between these two wires of the line. Yes or no? Because of the current in the transmission line, the magnetic field H is set up, as you can see along with the direction on the screen, the magnetic field H will be set up in the medium, in the dielectric medium that is present between two wires of the line. Am I right? And my dear, within the same segment of the transmission line, electric field E is also present, as you can see from the screen, directing from upper wire towards the lower wire. Yes or no? See, you have applied the voltage, the potential difference between the two wires of this line, and we have assumed that at certain instant of time, the upper wire is at positive potential and lower wire is at negative potential. So that means positive charge is building up in the upper wire and negative charge is building up in the lower wire. So because of that, electric field will be set up within the dielectric medium that is present between these two wires of the line, as you can see from the screen. Yes or no? The electric field is directed from positive to negative. So the electric field will be directing, as you can see from the screen. So my dear, what I am trying to convince you is that when you apply the high frequency voltage source at the source end, the magnetic field and electric field, they are set up within the dielectric medium present between these two lines of the transmission line, present between the two wires of the transmission line. And for assumed particular instant, the directions of E and H are, as you can see from the screen. So when we apply high frequency voltage to the transmission line, what we get? We get transverse electric and transverse magnetic field created within the medium present between two wires. Yes or no? What is transverse? Transverse means perpendicular. Perpendicular to what? Perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So this E and H that are created, these are transverse E and H. Yes or no? Check out, what is the direction of propagation? From source to load, this is the direction of propagation. So perpendicular plane to this direction of propagation will be the transverse plane. And as you can see from the screen, this E, as we have considered the small section of our transmission line, so E and H, they both lie on this transverse plane. Am I right? So my dear, I can say that for the transmission line, when we apply the high frequency voltage to the transmission line, the transverse E and H are set up within the medium that is present between the lines. That means transverse electromagnetic wave is set up. Yes or no? What is transverse E and what is transverse H? That is transverse electromagnetic wave. So my dear, this is the transverse electromagnetic wave that is set up within the material, within the medium, between two lines of the transmission line, between two wires of the transmission line. And because of this electromagnetic wave, because of this transverse electromagnetic wave, the power is propagated from source end to load end. Am I right? What is the direction of propagation of electromagnetic wave? Remember Poynting theorem, E cross H. Try to take E cross H over here. E is downwards, H is like this. So E cross H, it is directing along the load. Yes or no? You can take any instant of time, even though you reverse the directions of current, still you will get the direction of propagation towards load. So my dear, this is the visualization of your transverse electromagnetic wave over the transmission line, over the what did you get from this this illustration? One thing you can conclude, that the transverse electromagnetic wave, TEM wave, that is set up within the transmission line, it is set up within the dielectric material that is present between two wires of the transmission line. Yes or no? And because of that electromagnetic wave, the high frequency electromagnetic power, it is carried out from source to the load. Am I right? So I hope now you got the better visual idea. See, I have taken the small portion of transmission line, but it is valid for all the medium that is present. It is valid for all the length of the transmission line. Yes or no? So this is how transverse electromagnetic wave is set up for the transmission line system. So next week, let's meet with another mind-bending concept. Thank you.